Natasha Wheeler, and I'm a teacher at Nyambika School, Porvorim, and I teach English. My story, Faith Came Calling, is selected, I've been shortlisted for Novella's story writing competition. The story is about how faith can move mountains, but to hold on to that faith can sometimes be a challenge. So I hope you enjoy listening to my story. I stood in a daze, every part of me numb. This couldn't be happening. I was a brilliant student, on the brink of becoming a successful writer, and my world just crumbled before me. How could it be that the precious nuggets of my thoughts that I so securely had cast in my manuscript had been misplaced by the publishing office? There had to be a valid explanation for this unfortunate fiasco. I felt shattered. Perfectly woven plot by me was lost, or had it been robbed? The publishing house so conveniently stated that there wasn't any trace of it. To my misfortune, I didn't have a copy as I didn't own a computer, and I was naive enough to give my original work. It wasn't a time where people were so net savvy. Now there was only one option, and that was to rewrite the matter. Could I do it? Summer was about to end, and the school would begin in a week. How was I to recollect the matter? I felt lost and pathetic. I kept wandering around on my bicycle, trying to come up with a plot, but it was in vain. Finally, tired and thirsty, I came to an old chapel. The area was deserted, except for a dilapidated hut behind it. I parked my cycle in a nearby bush and went to the chapel. It was locked. What was I thinking, expecting the door to be open for me? Besides, if anyone saw me entering a chapel, I would be the laughing stock. I went around the back to the hut, but it seemed deserted. The hut had a cold, misty stench that gave me goosebumps. Walking around, I found a jar of some jam with a loaf of bread that was 2 to 3 days old. But beggars can't be choosers. I hid to my heart's content with a loud burp to express my gratitude. Suddenly, I heard footsteps and an old lady was at the door. I looked at her with a guilty gaze and she smiled. "Have you had your fill?" she asked. I smiled and nodded. She then asked me why I had wandered down this path, and listening to such a sympathetic voice, I blurted out my woes. After patiently hearing me out, she smiled and went about tidying the room. My pain? Can you not show me some pity? I roared in anger, but to no avail. She gave me a snort and said, "No, why should I mourn for such a trivial matter? In fact, why do you mourn for a trivial matter?" she said. I just stared at her, but let her continue. With a blazing fire of conviction, she spoke, "Fear not, my little one. This too shall pass, like a wave kissing the shore, taking with it twigs that prick a child's feet. Have faith, like that of a baby crying as he opens its eyes. He doesn't know if he will be soothed, but he still cries with an unfailing hope that his pain will cease in the embrace of his mother." She handed me a little black book and just put her palm over my eyes. To open my eyes, and when I did, I found myself inside the chapel holding the book, but the old lady wasn't there. I opened the book to a random page and read, "Do not fear, I will help you." Isaiah 41:13. I kept reading as if I was under its spell, and each time it was a new miracle that left me smitten. Suddenly, the pain of losing my manuscript had ceased. I felt revitalized and suddenly I felt someone nudging me. And when I looked up, it was my mum. I could see her lips but couldn't hear her and kept staring at her. She finally gave me a rough shrug and I could hear her telling me to get ready for church. I sat up straight and then realized it was a dream. My manuscript was missing. I quickly dressed for mass and went to church. After the mass was over, we made our way to our car and I had a tap on my back. It was a young girl. She handed me a parcel saying that her grandmother has sent it for me. And before I could say anything, she scurried away. I was aghast. How could this perfect stranger give me a parcel from her grandmother? To my surprise, I found the little black book. There was also a note that said, "The Lord's ways are mysterious, but blessed are they that trusted him without faltering." Signed, Faith. I burst into tears of joy. When we reached home, there was a blaring ring of the telephone. I rushed to it for something told me it is for me, and I picked it up. It was the publishing house. Apparently, my manuscript had been selected and was being reviewed by the editing team for its next book. I was so thrilled and leapt up in praise. It was the day that Faith came calling. So, the message in this story is basically to hold on to your faith no matter what happens. I hope you enjoyed my story.